giving just 3 days away now, and a local celebrity chef is making sure your table has some amazing food this year.
All right, Michael Simon has some tips on how to prepare your turkey and make sure none of your guests will leave hungry.
That's right. I had a chance to speak with him about his new cookbook that's out that's amazing, and also some great tips to help make your holiday even more special. Here with Michael Simon, and we're looking forward to Thanksgiving. You have your 8th cookbook out.
I know, it's crazy.
Oh my gosh, congratulations.
Thank you very much. It's been, and this one's done very well. It's probably our biggest seller so far, so we're excited.
Simply Simon Suffers. What I love is you have your mother's recipe in there for Sunday sauce. Yeah. You have great desserts, great cocktails, but this huge, and pardon my post-it notes, because they're pretty much on every page.
I
had to flag every page. And I didn't want to bend the corners because it's such a gorgeous book.
Thank you.
But you have a whole section dedicated to holidays.
Yeah, I think holidays are when, like, we did 52 weeks of dinners and then holidays also, because I feel holidays are when people stress out. So,
sure.
Like, I wanted to give them, like, here's recipes that we do that you could use. They're foolproof. Set it, and you're good.
I love the Thanksgiving stuff that you did, too.
Yeah.
Now, we've all had our Thanksgiving Day mishaps. My first turkey rolled down the stairs. After rinsing it off, my mom and I still cooked it, because what are you going to do Thanksgiving
fine,
morning?
It's going in the hot oven. It's
right.
Fine.
It kills everything,
yeah.
Right? Oh, you had a
I had a horrible... So, my grandfather... Pap, who I have a lot of his recipes in the book.
I loved my pap.
Corn pudding, which we do every Thanksgiving.
Yes.
He lived 103 years old, and he always did Thanksgiving. But when I was chef at Caxton Cafe 30 years ago, he's like, I want you to take over Thanksgiving. We're still new to my house, but I want
chef,
you to take over.
Right.
So I'm like, got it. So I'm going to do it. I order a turkey, a big turkey, and I season it at the restaurant, and I go to his house, and it doesn't fit in his oven. So I have
bottom
to,
drawer, you have it on the bottom.
Oh my God,
nothing.
Couldn't fit it.
Wouldn't go in.
So I have to go, I go back to the restaurant. My whole family's at my grandfather's house. And I go back to the restaurant by myself, cook the turkey by myself, and then bring it back to Pap's house for Thanksgiving dinner.
Oh my God.
Yeah, it's like when Liz and I built our first kitchen, the first thing I said is, this oven is gonna be big enough to fit any size turkey I wanna put in it.
What size was it, like a 30 pounder or
It wasn't a 30 pounder, but you know, he had it was an older house with an older oven, and you know, it just wouldn't go in.
That's awful.
It was terrible.
All right, well, hopefully you don't have any of those
no.
in this house. What are some of your suggestions this week, Thanksgiving? People are buying their
yes,
stuff now.
Yes, that's a good plan. I mean, get ahead, make a plan. Make even someone who's cooked their entire life like me, my plan is broken down to the, like, 10:45, do this. 10:50, do this. And I make a whole list for what I want to do 3 days before, 2 days before, day of. And the most important thing is, because there's so many things going on for Thanksgiving, make an oven schedule.
That's
so
a great
like
idea.
Your turkey goes in at this time. When the turkey comes out to rest, you could put in your X in the oven, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So you have a schedule of when you could use things. And you're Clevelanders, so you're tough when it's cold outside. If you get kind of crammed up on oven space, don't be afraid to use your grill as another oven outside.
Oh, good idea.
So you do have, you know, Clevelanders typically have a grill and they grill in the summer,
right.
But you could use that grill as a warmer or another oven, so to give yourself, free yourself up a little more space.
Right. What are some of your favorite dishes?
For the holidays? For Thanksgiving?
Thanksgiving.
So in the book, I have my grandfather's corn pudding. It's incredibly simple and delicious. There's a lot of, he used a Jiffy corn mix to make his corn pudding. And I grew up eating it, and I'm like, this is the greatest thing. And then when I became a chef, I'm like, I'm not using this corn mix stuff.
Jiffy.
I'm gonna use polenta, and I'm gonna make it fancy. And I made like a big chefy one. And everybody in my family's like, what did you do to the corn pudding?
Aww.
So now to this day, I still make Pap's recipe.
Stay with
it. And you could fancify it up a little bit if you want, but that's the one thing that has to be on our table or there's a riot. And this year we'll probably have 40 people for Thanksgiving. So
wow.
I do a lot of turkeys, but you know, if you're doing more than one turkey, like do a classic one. So like you have the show turkey. And I really think there's great benefits to either doing a spatchcock turkey or a broken down turkey, so it cooks faster
What's
and more evenly.
That?
So spatchcock is like if you, they do it with chickens a lot. If they cut the backbone out of the turkey, they could lay it flat.
Oh,
and
then
so
it will fit in the oven.
It will fit in the oven and it will cut your cooking time by half.
Really?
Yeah.
That's
by
fantastic.
Half. So if you're not like, oh, I need this big, you know, grand thing.
Beautiful
it, it cuts it in half. Also in the book, we always do a cheesecloth method with the turkey, which keeps it much more moist.
Well, here's Pabst corn pudding, which I already flagged last night because that looks so good. Amazing. The recipes for that. And then looky there.
Oh, the cheesecloth. Yeah. So you cover it in buttered cheesecloth and then you don't have to baste it. And you could see when you pull it off, that's not like magic of TV stuff.
That's gorgeous.
It just actually just gets golden and the skin is perfect every time. It's my grandfather taught me how to do this 40 years ago, and I've never done a turkey a different way.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Now you'll have 41 people over.
Come on,
I'll be there for Thanksgiving.